So Albania has a unique place in Europe for being the bastion of the Alevi Bektashi Order, which originates from Eastern Turkey, but was expelled by Ataturk in 1925, as the newly found Turkish Republic was in the process of overhauling the entire Turco-Persianate heritage of Anatolia. But during the Ottoman period, the Albanian-speaking territories of the Balkans had been a stronghold for this religious community since it made its way into the Balkans through the Janissary Corps, who had a huge presence there, and eventually became associated with the Albanian elite. The origins of this religious community derive from a mystic known as Haji Bektash Veli, who was born and lived in the city of Nishapur in eastern Iran, in Khorasan. His disciple, Balim Sultan, who was either like a Greek Muslim or some Anatolian Turk who was from Greece, founded an order under his name in eastern Anatolia, and many Turkmens who converted into this Sufi sect incorporated Turkic shamanism into its theological doctrines. The Iranian paganist religion of Manichaeism also has a huge influence inside the sect, too, because Bektashism is basically an esoteric and syncretic Islamic sect. And once it reaches the lands of what is known in political geography as Greater Albania, Orthodox Christianity gets thrown into the mix as well, because certain figures that are venerated in the Bektashi tradition have an Orthodox counterpart to them as well. As of now, they are the fourth largest religious community in Albania. There aren't really any Bektashis left in Turkey anymore, but there are more Turkmens who are Alevis in eastern Turkey now than there are Kurds or Zazas, but Alevis still represent about 20% or a bit more of the Iranic population in eastern Turkey. If you go to the Turkmen majority regions in Iraq and Syria, they're all Sunnis, at least the vast majority of them are. There may be some exceptions to the rule, but the Turkmen religion is predominantly Sunni. Iranians like the Persians and the Kurds have a stronger claim to the Bektashi order because, as I said before here, most Turks are Hanafi Sunnis. Most Sufi orders that originate from the period of Turco-Mongolian rule in West Asia, whether they were born inside Khorasan, somewhere in the Iranian plateau, somewhere in Anatolia, they all incorporated some aspects of Shiism into their doctrines. Shiism was growing in popularity after Mongolian rule wiped out the Sunni ulama, but most of them were still Sunni in outlook. But Bektashism is definitely more Shiite-oriented than the other orders, like, for example, you can just name a couple. And this is where I end my dissertation. Thank you for watching.